Like said, my name is Dr. Stephen Karanja, the chairman of the Kenya Catholic Doctors Association, and we wish to propose, and we have proposed before, that the Reproductive Healthcare Bill 2019 be withdrawn from the Senate in totality. And this we should have seen that in 2014, when a similar bill was brought in by CJ, by Senator CJ Judith, the then CS education, Jacob Kaimenyi, said something very fundamental and astounding, which still exists today because these bills are still the same, that he will not allow, that the country will not allow introduction of immorality to young school children by any institution and all law. Senator Susan Kehika took this bill in 2019. And the new bill is exactly a copy of the CJ bill, except that they say that now for this one, that the children can be given these things without, can be given contraception with the parental consent. What are the reasons that the Kenya Catholic Doctors Association, what are the reasons? Why do we want this bill removed? Number one, the engine of this bill is abortion. And it needs to be understood that for any reason or demand, that in fact, these bills states clearly, if you read it, that abortion should be on demand for any reason and after the birth of a child. If you look at part four of the bill, it deals with the termination of pregnancy and termination of pregnancy. Deliberately means to stop or hold or end the life of a baby for undefined reasons throughout pregnancy. This bill does not even give one definition of why the baby should be killed. Undefined emergency treatment. Again, the emergency is not defined. There, remember, there is no medically known emergency treatment that require a baby to be killed. Repeat, as a doctor of many years, I know this to be sure, that there is no medically known emergency treatment that require a baby to be killed. And when this bill proposes this, it's absolutely unacceptable. There are, we know, abnormal pregnancies medically classified as diseases, including ectopic pregnancy and molar pregnancy. And when these occur, any trained person knows that these are diseases rather than normal pregnancies, and their treatment is clearly explained in medical books. If you look at 26.1, Article 26.1 of this bill, B, it justifies the slaughter of these children of Kenya, our tomorrow, our future, based on the life and the health of the mother. Now, everybody should know that health was defined in 1948 by World Health Organization as the mental, as physical, mental, and social well-being, and not only the absence of disease or infirmity. For social reason, any social reason that a woman can have, she can demand that the baby can be killed, that the baby should be killed. There does not exist something worse than this that any country can adapt. I would want members of the Senate, look at 26.1C. It is a shocking proposal from the framers of this bill, because they boldly claim the deep reason why they supported this bill.
Yeah.
That those babies thought to have a physical or mental abnormalities must be killed. If a baby is thought, not even known to have physical or mental abnormality must be killed. And this is not surprising. This is pure eugenics. Remember, dear honorable senators, that like in Nazi Germany, it is intended to discriminate, demonize, and kill the imperfect. It has happened before, remember, and they want it to happen here. And I promise you, if this bill is not stopped by you, next you will hear a bill to kill all handicapped in the country. Kenya Catholic Doctors is not surprised by this, because the more than 25 sponsors and supporters of this bill who bought a page on the July 5th, 2020, in the Daily Nation, in support of this bill, are known throughout the world. They are fueled by eugenics, racism, neo-colonial and exploitative philosophy. This bill is a bill of death. It is actually exo-Hippocratic. The Hippocratic oath is based on the principle primum non nocere. Primum non nocere means that first do no harm. When you practice outside Hippocratic medical ethics, by even imagining killing a normal baby, you become a criminal. Now you are practicing witchcraft. This, therefore, honorable senators, is an abortion bill. It calls for the genocide of our unborn babies as a country. It is the type of bill that should call, and I am not exaggerating here, it calls for the arrest of the proposers of genocide of Kenya. You senators represent all the Kenyan people, most of them not highly educated or sophisticated. They are poor, weak, and exploited majority. Their eyes are trained on you. Please, senators, open your eyes and see that.
You and what is the music, please, Sylvia? Music.
Mute
those guys. Okay. Thank you. Proceed, Dr.
Dear senators, because you represent all of us, most of us are poor, weak, and exploited majority. Our eyes are trained on you. Please open your eyes and see that UNDPA, UNFPA, IPPF, International Planned Parenthood Federation, Marie Stopes, IPAS, World Health Organization being defunded now for its criminal behavior, and the World Bank are the children and descendants of a people that have consistently considered the people of Africa as subhuman. They are forefathers of these sponsors and supporters of this bill, are the same people who enslaved our forefathers. They viciously exterminated the Red Indians in the Americas, Aborigines and the Maori in Australia and New Zealand. Their main purpose is depopulation of Africa so that they can harvest the resources. That is why they sponsor this bill of abortion, discrimination of the handicapped and death. This abortion, remember, abortion is a multi-billion industry throughout the world. And this is the reason the foreign NGOs working for their various counties or groups of racists will look for local collaborators that they can pay. And believe it, dear senators, a lot of Kenyans are greedy, and they will take any money and sell Kenyans and destroy a country because of greed. This is a brazen attempt by Western abortion organizations to impose abortion up to the time of birth on Kenya. to have these well-funded overseas organizations spending lots of money to force abortion on Kenya when various studies in this country, including one done recently by KCPF, shows over 90% of our people hold that abortion is morally unacceptable. This is actually ideological colonialism. And this is rooted in deep racism and imperialistic attitudes. And their aim is to actually disseminate, destroy the population of this country. What does this bill stand on? Like we said, for it to stand, it must have legs on which to stand. The first one, like we have said, is abortion. For without abortion, the external governments cannot achieve what they have always wanted to achieve, that is control of our people. Number two, contraception. It says over and over again about adolescent reproductive health. Adolescents, they define them as starting from 10 years to 17 years. Senators, you are all parents and grandparents. You have in your homes 10-year-old children. Should these children be given contraception? Are they even mature enough to have sex? When this country, and mainly through you, our dear honorable senators, accept this ruthlessness to be allowed in this country, then this country will go, like many other countries, to the dead. So, contraception is a multi-billion industry in the world. The owners, the main owners of contraception are number one, IPPF, International Planned Parenthood Federation. They are the owners. Population Council, which is part of them, they are the ones that own these contraceptives. And therefore, they go to the third leg with which they stand, sexualizing the children. Just imagine, they do not only want to sexualize children up to 10 years. They won't even go younger. Children of any age, people of all ages, are entitled to information about reproductive health. That means even below 10 years. For the pilot they did in 30 schools in this country, what they were teaching children is actually how to have sex, how for children to put on condoms, what to touch and where to touch. It is obnoxious completely. And it is extremely important that you as parents, and we as parents too, must stand up. Whether we are poor or not, outsiders will not come here and rape our children. Mentally, especially developmentally, as they grow, and then tell us that we must accept to agree with them because they have what it takes. For us, we are Christian doctors who practice our art according to the Hippocratic oath. Number two, absolute clear-cut medical excellence. And number three, according to our faith. And our faith is extremely important to us because as we work, we are also parents of children. And because we are parents of children, we need to give them the example. And I can imagine any of you
expecting. Sorry, for how long? Sorry, Dr. Karanja, for how long do you want to continue? I think we have exhausted the time.
Can I have 2 minutes?
Okay, fine. Thank you.
Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, sir. I just wanted to say that because we are Christians and this bill does not even only attack Christians, it actually even wants to imprison those doctors who refuse to kill babies. Either they find them or they imprison them if they refuse. What kind of bill is expected to be supported in this country? Now, this bill imprisons Christian doctors because the sponsors of this bill threaten Christian practice. We also have the courage spiritually to defend the truth. We demand that the sponsors, supporters, and collaborators of this bill clear here. I want to say what we feel because all the members of Kenya Catholics agree on this, that these people be arrested in this country because they are proposing genocide of the children. Instead of arresting Christian doctors for refusing to kill God's children, we demand the arrest of the collaborators. And they should be charged with the treason against Kenya and also conspiracy to commit genocide and crimes against humanity under the Nuremberg proceedings. In conclusion, evidently, the Reproductive Health Care Bill Senate of 2019 promotes the above pillars and seeks to introduce things that are unacceptable in this country. The abortion of this bill, therefore, will not only contravene the laws of Kenya, but it will also disregard the cultural values and the faiths of the people of Kenya. We submit that this bill, in part or in its entirety, has no place in the Republic of Kenya and should be expunged from the Senate completely. May God bless this land and nation. Thank you, Chairman. Thank you, Senators.
Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Karanja. Appreciate it. You have said whatever you wanted to say with a lot of vigor, and you have told us what you really, how you feel about it. Thank you very much. We have heard you.
Thank you, Chairman.
We have heard you. Thank you. Next, we go to the Kenya Christian Professional Forum.